So, first I will introduce the ellipsific integers. So, what I mean with ellipsific, ellipse integers, it is integers with missing digit. So Christian proposed to introduce this term ellipsific because when we were working on this subject, we were working in French, and we tried to find a nice way to define this. Things in French. So in French, we say chiffre manquant, entier dont l'écriture dans une base donnée n'a pas certains chiffres. It was too long and not satisfactory. And so Christian proposed to build this word with some Greek. So here it will be mean missing or manquant in French. And here it will be the digit. And we found that it was a very good idea, and it's a nice word, and I hope that now this word will be used frequently. And I think it is already the case, and there are some papers this year published with ellipsific number. So now I will give a rigorous definition. So an example of families of ellipsific numbers, it is the numbers without the digit 9, in the basis 10 expansion. And so more generally, we can fix R, a basis, and we give a set of digits, D, a subset between 0 and R minus 1, the digit, and so we want that the cardinality of D is at least, D has at least two elements, but D is not all the digits. We want to remove some digits. And thus, the ellipsific digit is the set, the ellipsific integer, sorry, it is the set of the integers of the form N, equal n to the summation of g equals to 0 some to some k, ag r to the g, will all the digit ag belongs to d. And so, and w do the digit, the ellipsific number less than x will be denoted by this. And so now, to make the formula easier, it is good to suppose that 0 belongs to D. And also, that the element of D are coprime. And so now, Coquet studied already in the 80s some family of sets. And in the 90s, there was some results on the distribution of the ellipsific numbers in arithmetic progressions. And so we consider this set here. It will be the set of the integer n ellipsific such that n is congruent to A mod Q. And there was a very beautiful result of Paul Ardoche, Christian Mauduit, and András Sarkozy. And so they prove that there exist two positive constants, C1 is depending on R on the set D. Such that for so the all the integers A in Z, so the Q we will suppose in order to make the formula more shorter, we suppose that Q is coprime to R times R minus 1. And Q less than this constant C1, square root of log x, so x large enough. And so the idea is to say, so what they prove, it proves that the distribution is good. So we would like to estimate the cardinality of this set. And so we, if the distribution is good, we expect that this cardinal here is a cardinal of that divided by Q. And they obtain an upper bound with here a constant depending also on R and D. So what it was expected, times minus C2 log X by log Q. So this result says that there is a good distribution when Q is less than that, and we can compare this result with the classical theorem of Ziegler-Wallfisch on the distributions of prime numbers in arithmetic progressions. So I will try to give you an idea of the proof of this. And so the standard way to examine this problem, it is to use exponential sums. So we have WD of X AQ. It is, we detect the congruence here by an exponential. The summation of H equal 1 to Q, and then and so with the standard notation E of t, I have place here. And thus, an important part is to evaluate what we call now the Fourier transform on the indicatrice of the ellipsific integers. It is this function, f of n d, of, so I will put here, h of q, because we are interested in that. And it is the summation of n ellipsific e of h n divided by q. And when x is of shape r to the n, so for the proof I will suppose that x is the power of r, this can be written as a finite product. So it will be the product of all the G here. Ouais, bon, tant pis. all the G, the summation of all the digit D, E, H over Q, D, R to the Q. In fact, here I have put here, I should put 0 to have this formula. And here it is not K, it is N. The N here. And thus, I will, so they denote by UD of H of K R to the K this this term. And then if we are able to obtain a non-trivial bond of UD, even if this bond is very small, when we put it in the product, we can win a lot. And that this is what they did. So it will be the lemma. They did that in two steps. So lemma 2, c'est for alpha real. What they did that UD of T, of alpha. So here, so I will write T is the number of elements of D. So a trivial bond for UD, it will be the number of terms of the sum, that is T, the cardinality of D. So they prove that it is less than T times 1 minus the distance of alpha to the integers divided by R minus 1 to the 5. So what it is important is not really the dependence of R, it is to have such universal bond with here alpha is the distance of alpha to the integer. And so we put that here, and then we use the fact that 1 minus this, it is less than the exponentials minus this. And if we put here, we are led to compute, to bond the summations of some here with that here. So it is the aim of this next lemma. So they have a more general form. So they take beta real, m or q bigger than we want that the n here bigger than 2 log q to the log r. That is, that q is bigger than the square root of r to the n, square root of the x, plus a term. And then they proved that the summation of all the k, and what we wanted here, it was beta plus r to the k time h. It's bigger than r minus 1 for and so this result has been the lemma. So there are some, after this result, there are some improved versions of these lemmas, but it was the first lemma of this shape, and it was very useful. And for example, recently, Christian Mauduit, Karam Alaoui, so So here, I have forgotten to say that it is a lemma of Wolf and Rusch. And this lemma here, it was proved by András and Christian. And it is complicated lemmas to prove, not easy to obtain some lemmas like that. And Mohamed Mkawar, perhaps Mohamed will speak on that on this talk, I don't know. And so what they obtain, they study the distribution in arithmetic progressions. Ellipsific on palindrome integers. A palindrome, what is it? It is an integer whose expansion in a given basis is symmetric. For example, 7.47 or something like that. Voilà. And also they obtain some result of this kind, and furthermore they put in this another condition of the sum of digits of these integers. So here it was very recent, so two design, something like that. And Paul Erdős, Christian Moody, and András Sarkozy remark also that the distribution is good, but not so good. For example, some class of congruence can be missed even when the modulus Q is a small power of X. But in many applications, we need only result on average. So a natural continuation of this work was to try to find average results like the Bombieri-Vinogradov theorems from the primes. And it is what I did with Christian, and also in the same period, Sergei Konyagin obtain such a result. It is the following theorem. And, so we did that quite in the same period. And what we prove is that there exists an alpha depending on R and T, such that for all capital B positive, like the Vinogradov theorems for the power of log X, there exists A positif with, alors, the summation. It is an average summation, so we will take all the Q less than X to the alpha divided log X to the A. And to simplify here the formula, we will suppose a Q co-prime with R, R minus 1. And so we want to, as before, approximate this cardinality by this. And these things, so on average, there is a good distribution, it is. To the B. So, and so we obtain that. And what is the ingredient of the proof? So I will go quickly. So we use lemma 2 and lemma 3. So it is a theorem like large shift things, and so some large shift method. And what we need also, it is to compute, to bound the moment of the function f and d. And so, we need to evaluate mainly, it is the ingredient of the proof. And so we can also mix some powers in here to win a little, to obtain better exponents. And so now we will, when we have an argument like that, we can use sieve method and they take not primes already, but almost primes. It is the next section. Primes. Or. Almost prime. Ellipsific. So I will. Oh, yeah, stop. What, so if we apply a theorem 4, plus sieve methods, we arrive at theorem 5. So it was with Christian and me. And now what we prove that there exists an integer k, like that, such that the number of ellipsific integers is at most k prime factors is bigger than w d of x divided by log x, so omega of n, it is the number of prime factors of n. And when it is important here, it is to have the k smallest as possible. And so I will give some examples. Here we can, in fact, if the d are precise, we can obtain a precise value, admissible value of alpha. So here I will begin with some extremal cases when d has only two elements. So the integers, we only need the digit 0 and 1 in the base are expansions. And so I should put here, so for example, for r, is equal to 3, the exponent alpha here is a little bigger than 1 divided by 3. So it is a 0.34. And so with some weighted sieve, we can detect, we can take k is equal to 3. Or r is equal to 4. We were able, we can take, so here, so alpha was only 1 over divided by 4, and so the sieve method is not so efficient, and we arrive at 5. For r is equal to 10, if I remember when we obtained something like that, 23. And when r is bigger and bigger, we have k, it is something when r is going to infinity. So when r begins big, we have that. And for k is equal, we can also manage for k is equal to 2. We obtain various estimation. So I will only quote this result. If we take all the digits but not the last one, r bigger than but 2, 5, then we can take k is equal to 2. So this, all these results were obtained in the beginning of this century. And thus it was before the Moody River Revolution when they proved the conjecture of Gelfond. So after that there was the proof. So with I put like that. So I will go quickly because I think there will be some talks during this week on that. Proved two conjectures of Gelfond. On sum of digits of prime, the sum of digits of the square, and so it gave a lot ideas for many problems in this era. And we guess it was possible to obtain some result with k is equal to 1. And this has been done by James Minard. So he was so we take d, all the digits except 1, what we want, and the base r. So he was able to obtain the base 10, which is for us the most important, and he proved that the number of p ellipsific with such d is what we expected, log x. And there are also some results of Irving for palindromes. So we only put his name. Alistair Irving, in his thesis, obtained some results for the palindrome with 3 digits. So 3 digits, it is ellipsific when the base is bigger than 4. And with at most 2 prime factors. So another interesting problem is to find ellipsemphic numbers not with few primes but in the opposite directions with many small primes. And it is the next section. It will be 4 friable ellipsemphic. So what I mean with friable, it means without large prime factors. And thus I will consider the function p plus of n. It is the largest prime factors of n. And in this paper, András Sarkozy, Christian Mauduit, Paul Erdős prove that there are many, infinitely many ellipsemphic numbers, so, such that all their prime factors are less to the n plus to the epsilon. I will write it, it will be perhaps more easy. So, to see, so Paul Erdős, Christian Mauduit, András Sarkozy proves there exist there are infinitely many n such that p plus of n are less to the n to the epsilon, and of course n is ellipsemphic. So in fact it is with d contain 1 or 0. It is integers with only digits 1. So, But this sequence is quite thin. Natural questions is to ask if there are positive if there are positive proportions of such integers. And for all epsilon positive, it is very difficult. It seems to be a bit out of reach, but why not? Perhaps after all this works, perhaps it is possible when the basis is very large. And in fact, to have an asymptotic things. And Sylvain Coll. He proved that there exists alpha, such that the number of ellipsific positive integers, purpose of n less than n to the alpha, there is a positive proportions of such integers. And in fact, what I say, when if alpha is very positive, when the basis R is large enough in terms of alpha, it can also solve these problems with D, with a lot of D. I will try to finish, but I have many things to say. So I will quote recent works also from on ellipsific integers in, how to say, Vinogradov systems. So what is a Vinogradov systems? It is systems of Diophantine problems arising, for example, in Waring's problems. Ah, yes, I was writing. Alpha belong, depends of R and D, strict positive. So I can write some, do you want some values of alpha? So for D equal to 0, 1, an example. So for each size shape of D, you can obtain an alpha. So when D is very small, I have to find it. Is here. So here we have a very thin set, so the alpha is very close to 1, but yes, alpha is less than 1 because it will be more easy otherwise. And alpha, it is 1 minus P, like that, 1 minus 3P. So this result are in his thesis, and unfortunately it wasn't published. But there are also when you consider the set with all the digits without one, the alpha can be very small if the bias here is going to infinity. And so the Vinogradov systems, it is systems of shape we have to solve, x1 to the j plus xs to the g equal to Y1, oui, it is an S. Y, S to the J with, and recently there was very deep result of Bourguin and Demeter, and so to give, to solve these questions. And, but Kirsty Briggs, studied with these problems with x by supposing that xe and the y are is I ellipsific, and she obtained a general formula complicated to enounce in all this generality. But what I can put, it is the easiest case, it is when k is equal to 2, and so she was interested by the particular set, so with R is the prime number P, and she takes all the square with D less than square root of P, and here if she count the its I here, if WD of X, On the bone she obtained, it is, so the trivial bone would be the number of variables here, to the S. And then she can win a 6 plus epsilon. And here for S bigger than 6. And so what we can see, it is when S is equal to C, we have mainly only the diagonal terms in this systems. So I will finish. I will try to. May I have 5 minutes? Okay. Thank you. And so I wanted to add that in her paper she used the term ellipsific, but not number set. And there are some link with additive theory because she's interested with set by counting the repetitions, like the Sidon problem. So there are some repetitions, so for the people working in additive number theory, I think this paper may be interesting for her. It will be soon on archive. So the last section, it will be ellipsific numbers, but with infinite fields. So I will take Q, a prime power, and recently Andras and me have defined the notion of digits in finite fields. So perhaps we wasn't the first to do that, but we work on that. So how we can do that? We take a basis B. So perhaps it will be more clear if we take a special like that. A basis of FQ over FP. So if we take an X in FQ, we can write F in this form. And so, and here we can interpret the coefficient C as digits, with 0, 0. And thus we take also some missing digits, so we take D, a set of digits, as before with with at least 2 elements, and with but not all the digits. And here, but in finite fields, the life is easier than the natural integers, because you know, and the integral for the natural integers, it is very difficult to find polynomial value with a given sum of digits and something like that. It is very, and here we can do quite everything, not everything, but many things. What we will do. So we will take WLD, it will be the sum of like that. Z is in D, and we were interested with if we take a polynomial f, we would like to study the ellipsific polynomial values of f. It is the following set. Christian Andrasch and me obtained some asymptotic results of the cardinality of this set. We would compare it with the cardinality of WD. So if so it is the last theorem, So. So we want to approximate WD of F with the cardinality of WD. And so what we prove, so we have the square root of Q . So, in fact, when d is small, this result is not really interesting. This result is interesting when the proportion of digits of d is strictly positive and, in fact, large enough. So, when d is a set of consecutive numbers, we can do better. And also, recently, if for f of x equal to the x square, yeah, better result. I'm sorry not to be very precise, obtained by Rainer Dittmann, Christian Elsholtz, and Igor Szpalinski. And I will also say that there are also a lot of results not for ellipsific in finite fields, but for other problems with digits in finite suites, by these results are obtained by Cathy Svenepel. So thank you very much for your attention.